Hello, so in this video, I'm going to be taking these coordinates here that are in longitude, latitude, and putting them into ArcMap. And most people get these like an Excel spreadsheet like this. Couple quick notes, these should be in decimal degrees. Also, pay attention to your negative signs and your positive signs. If you're in the Western Hemisphere, you should be having a negative sign. Or if you're in the Southern Hemisphere, same thing. Here you can see with my latitude and longitude that I'm located somewhere in North America. And so it's just something to watch out for. Anyways, whenever you're about to take this over to ArcMap, what you want to do is first you want to save it. And in ArcMap, you can open Excel spreadsheets natively. But one thing that I like doing is I like closing Excel because I don't want to have a sharing violation. Once you do that, go ahead and go into ArcMap and you can hit the Add Data button. I have this hanging on my desktop. And so I'm going to go here to my desktop under my folder connections. If I don't see my desktop under my folder connections, then you'll just have to click here and connect to a new folder and connect to your desktop. Go to my desktop. I have the Excel spreadsheet. Once I open that, you're going to see that there is the sheet, the individual sheet. In my case, I only had one sheet. If you have three sheets, most likely it's on book one. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead here and hit add. Anytime I add in a table into ArcMap, I want to make sure that I actually added in correctly. And so go ahead and open it and see what it shows up as. And you can see here I have my long and my lat, that's good, and the point name. Sometimes there could be an issue if the data comes in with the wrong type. Right now this is on a double, which is what I want. But if it came in as a text, that can be an issue. So if that does happen, just go ahead and add a field. Make that, call something like, you're not able to add a field yet because you need to export the table in order to do that. But if that does happen, first step is export the table under data, export data. Go ahead and say here, add a field. And then once you get that field added, go ahead and calculate the field calculator and just set it equal to that one. Make your new field a double so then you can fix that string problem. So, but in this case, we have doubles, which is great. So anyways, everything checks out there. And so to make this into XY data, the best way to do this is to right click it and choose display XY data. Once you do that, it's going to ask you some questions. We know that the longitude is going to be the X field. And so it's automatically picking that from the name long. But you want to choose that as your X field. And then your Y is your lat field. Now, whenever you get coordinates, 99.9% of the time it's going to be WGS84, which is great. It could be NAT83 in some cases in North America. In other parts of the world, they might have different datums that are being used, but most likely it's WGS84 if you're using internet or if you're using GPS. But you can see here there's a problem. I see WGS84 and I think, okay, great, but if I run that, it's actually going to be broken. I need not to be working in a projected coordinate system. You need to be only working in a geographic coordinate system because they're just points. So what you're gonna wanna do is you wanna hit edit on the projection and get out of this web mercator. Most likely you're a web mercator also because that's the default for the base maps in ArcMap. And so most likely that's what it's gonna do. Anyways, you just switch over to geographic and then go over to the world. And then from there you can choose WGS84. And I just usually take the normal one, okay? There's some other options, variations of it, but just take WGS84. Once you say OK and this says only WGS84, those points are going to come in correctly. Now, if I hit OK, and if it does say something about an object ID field, you can go ahead and add that. That's great. So I got these points now that got added in. And if I want to go now, I want to go make sure that these points are in the correct place in the world. And the easiest way to do that is to go ahead and add in a base map and see where they pop up. So let's go ahead and add this base map. It doesn't matter which one you choose. Let's go to National Geographic. And with the project on the fly, that's going to overlay those points exactly where they should be if they're in the correct place. And so let's see what we get underneath it. Yes, great. That's what I was having the points in, near in North Central Florida. And so if I switch this here, this will probably make it easier to see it. Let me just change it over to something colorblind friendly. Maybe a bright blue. Well, maybe that's not bright enough. Just go with black. Make them bigger so you can see the points. But here you can see that these points here are there. Also, one thing that's kind of cool about this is that this data set, whenever you open the attribute table, you'll see that the attributes like the name 0.1 came in. You could have other attributes that you can add in Excel before you add in, and that's good. But one big thing now, so whenever you're done with this, you're not done, because this is all being held in virtual memory right now. None of this is permanent. And so you want to save this work. You don't want to save this in the ArcMap document like this, because it most likely will get corrupted in future iterations and then you'll have to start over. So what you want to do is, at this point, you want to right click the data and say export data. And this is going to take it from this virtual connection to the Excel spreadsheet to an actual shapefile. And so whenever you export that, I suggest exporting as a shapefile. You call this points, but another option is exporting it as a geodatabase. So if you do export as a geodatabase, that's fine, of course. And I'll just show you that quickly too, how you can do that. But the thing that a lot of new users get tricked on for the geodatabase export is that whenever they go here, they don't switch it to geodatabase. And whenever you do switch it, the next issue that can come up is that you can't just save here, because this is just a folder. So you actually have to have a geodatabase to save in. I already have a geodatabase hanging out in my documents folder. You can see here. But if you don't have a geodatabase already, you just hit this button here, new geodatabase, and you can make one. Once you get into that geodatabase, then you can go ahead and save your points here. Just remember, when you're saving geodatabases, it has to be in .gdb in order to save. And that's the big problem that people have. Hit OK. That's also saved out. So that's it. That's how you convert from Excel spreadsheet, longitude, latitudes, and bring them into ArcMap for a shapefile.